thinking fast and business. I stayed up by playing smart and ducking bad decisions. I wore hand-me-downs to class, bitches laughed at niggas. Now I rock designer like I'm in the fashion business. I met a plug when I was broke, not to brag, I did it. I broke a nine off a half and got in traffic with it. This for my day one fans, niggas that been listening. You know these rappers not better or as consistent. And when they talk about the streets, it ain't that specific. So I'm a tad suspicious if it's fact or fiction. You ain't in the streets weighing slabs of fishes, nigga. You just another rapper trying to have an image, but don't want the scabs or stitchy shit that gon' win. And if you ask me, this backwards, nigga. I seen too many real niggas fall to let you bitch niggas beat me. But still, I make this shit look easy. Bitches think I'm lit cause they see me, but I was just in a trap with a flip phone stick and a TV. Calls from home saying, "Why you going through the roof?" There's rumors back here saying, "Well, who going through the hoop?" Been gone for 2 weeks with two more funerals. They pulled up dumping out of a judo Super Bowl. It's all the same, this what we call a game. When you move and put you back like a ball and chain. We rap about our real life cause it caused us pain. When you reach certain levels, it causes change. The pain subside, but the scars remain. I'm one of the realest nigga that's broad as day. I'm on my Biggie, who shot ya? This for my partner still in lockup, who only called back home to tell us in a box up. They killed Eric Garner just cause his posture. But you get life if you hit a cop up. How could we feel like that's not us? I scan plexion the same, nigga, please don't be obnoxious. I play with more keys than a locksmith. It's like I'm good at everything, I got this.
What about Jaquan? Reminds you of old days back at Love Park?
It's very similar to any plaza around the world. It's very reminiscent of Embarcadero, Freedom Plaza, and also Love Park. And also we have Muni, right? And then we have Makba. The whole plaza culture of skateboarding is what skateboarding really is. It's always a place in the world where you can gather around and you can get clips at that particular spot. Los Angeles was never really like a plaza kind of a town. When we grew up watching all the kids from Los Angeles, they always skated schoolyards. But not only that, they always went to certain designated spots. Lockwood was somewhat, it wasn't a plaza, but it was a schoolyard, but that was their, that's kind of like their plaza here in LA.
Yeah, Coach Cooley.
Yeah, you already know.
Go ahead and give him the history, man. Go ahead and give him the history. Give him the mathematics, man.
Jaquan has always been rooted in Los Angeles. And you know, you've seen it in the blind videos, old blind videos. Gabriel Rodriguez, he skated here. He's probably one of the first people to skate here. Paulo Diaz, Fabian Alomar, Joey Surreal, all of them. Yeah. We grew up with them. Rest in peace to Gabriel Rodriguez, man. That was, he was a really good, he was a really good friend of mine. May he rest in peace, man. I think about him all the time. You know what I'm saying? You know, Josh Kaler, he came. He was really the first one to kind of like make it into that, give it that scene and that vibe. He's driving all the way up here from San Diego just to skate it. You got Josh Kaler, right? He came and established it. Like, you're going to skate here every day on Sunday. Then eventually, from them skating here all the time, they knobbed the legends. Then somebody came along, I don't want to say his name. They unknobbed them. Now here we are, skating again, and now we're in the Stevie Williams phase.
But man, make sure y'all like, subscribe, and share, you know what I'm saying? Repost, all that, man, you know what I'm saying? DGK TV. Make sure y'all tap in, man.
Yeah, sure.
We out. Take on Sunday
all day and night.